They've asked me to continue sitting on a steering group, which was very specifically looking at peer-to-peer mentoring, and that was a project that was in place before I took the role in August. However, they have told me that I am no longer to make any statements publicly as mental health champion. So from that statement, what I garner is that they still want the benefits of being associated with me, but they just don't want me to say anything which might embarrass them. And let me be absolutely clear, you know, one of my instincts when this story broke was just to hide under a table and wait for it all to blow over. But, you know, I've been in this role for 9 months. I've been going into schools and campaigning on mental health for 9 years. I'll be fine. I'll just carry on doing what I've always done. But when I first took the role, I said to the department, what I want to do is I want to bring the concerns of young people and the people who teach them to government level. So it's not actually me that's being silenced. It's young people and teachers, and that's why I'm here.